Hi guys, how are you doing? The reason I'm doing it over here because I want to show you guys the plot behind me. We having the finger root plant somewhere along this plot. There's quite a lot that we having here. Anyhow, today I would like to share with you a very quick tip on how to duplicate or propagate the finger root. Okay, so finger root have a few types and you not know which one to use. There is a local species and also another two more for commission that is there growing in the farm. How it does look like? It look like this. Okay, this is actually this is the head of the finger root. Okay, and then this is the part that actually grow from here. They were growing from here. The several root look like a finger, look like that. So when we having this, actually we will just pluck it out. Okay, and this part normally is the part that we use for the ingredient for the local kitchen. They are using a lot of this as the ingredient for cooking. It's having a very nice fragrance and juicy look like that. Okay, this is the time that after we collecting it, we usually we have to clean it up first. We need to wash it well and remove all the dust and soil that come together with the finger root. The reason is that all the diseases and it can cause the damage for this. If you don't wash it nicely, you wash and you dry it, and after that I trim it from here, and this part I trim it very nicely. So this part is like it's ready to use. Okay, it's ready to use. And normally if you are doing selling it and packaging to sell, this is the part that actually I'm using it to do the packaging and send to the customers, because the reason is that you can use this for 100%. Okay, the finger root normally if you are having around 10 kg, harvesting like this is only about 6 kg plus only. The rest is cannot be used. So if you get the selling in the market, you need to compare the price a little bit, whether you getting it, the whole thing it can be used or not. If they're selling the whole thing to you, and then you need to separate out the part of the other things and remove some of the not nice one out and all this, the weight and the price you have to check a little bit. Okay, this one will be available in our Shopee. You can check out the Shopee My Orca Fresh, and we do have fresh finger root and also the juice and the powder form as well. After that, this part, what we're gonna do with it, usually we don't use this for cooking. Okay, we use it to grow and propagate it. And what you can do is that when you're having this, actually you can removing it. If not, it will be too congested when you grow. Okay, I would like to show you a little bit more. Okay, you can break it up just like that. And what happened is that if you look carefully, the finger root, they have a young shoot coming out. Those young shoot is somewhere here. This is the part that is actually is going to grow to the new plant. Okay, and this is as well. So some of the healthy one, it can come up 3 or 4 plants. And when you want to propagate this and growing this, what we're gonna do is that prepare the soil. Okay, the common problem with the finger root is the one common problem is the rotting root. Okay, when it's using the soil, you have to use those very good at the niche. But to propagate this from the haven't grow yet like this, okay, to the young plant, I using the peace moss. So when I use the peace moss, what I want to control is that the timing of water the plants and also the quantity that the water that you gonna water the plants. So with this good well control, you will be able to solve the problem on the soil being too soggy, and that it might cause the plant to rot. Okay, so when you want to grow this, what you can do is that you can see this part is gonna shooting up this way. So you don't use this young the butt here to face down like that. If you use it face down like that, what is gonna happen is that when the young shoot struggling to grow, it will have to grow down, and then it will slowly looking for the sunlight and then coming up. That way it take a very long time for the plants to grow. So you put it at the side like that. Okay, at the side like that. Same thing go with this. Okay, here the shoot is pointing up this way. Okay, pointing up this way. We're gonna place it down like that. So now, normally the finger root, we're gonna grow it for about 30 cm by 30 cm. Before we move it to the plot, you can make it a little bit closer. Like this one, the shoot is real fast, it's gonna grow already. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do it that way. So same thing with the rest. The soil, I'm not make it too compact. I will just leave it like that and then press down very little. Okay, something like that. Okay, now if you are relocate this into the pot or into the planter, you don't need to cover with the soil. Just make sure that it's pressing down somewhere halfway. Like that is good enough because this soil, however, is the moisture is very good. So it's okay. Even with this one, even you put it under the hot sun, direct sunlight, open air, you will not gonna burn until this part is too dry. It won't happen. Don't worry about that, okay? So normally for the big type of a vegetable or the seed, we normally will have the very lightly put the soil on top like that. It's protecting the sun, the heat from the sun to burn the seed. So this one actually no need. It will help even better for the young bud, the shoot, to grow it, and you can monitor it whether this one is rot or not. Okay, if you find that there is the rotting root and all this kind of head, please don't use it. Quickly throw it away in the dustbin, okay? Because the reason is that this is a disease of the rotting root. I will talk more about it. And Gracha, if you want to do well and you want to do as a commission, there is a certain tips to take care of the Gracha. Okay, I can guide you through all the way, but it has to be a few episodes actually. So what happened for this when you already grow to this stage and then you just water it one times a day. You don't do it too frequent, okay? And if there is a rain, heavy rain or something like that, you avoid watering it. And when you can water it again, you stick your finger in. If you stick your finger in and then it's still moist like that, it's still wet, you can feel the moist, the water is in your hands there, your finger there, means that you don't need to even water the plant again. You have to wait. All right, this is after 1 month, what happened, this is what happening. All this is doing very well, but some of them might take a little bit longer time to grow, okay? And we're gonna wait. For this, it's already this size, when you have about two leaves. This one, another leaf open up like that, this is ready for repotted already, okay? Or relocated to the pot or the planter. You can do this straight away for the home grow. You can grow it in the pot nicely. For the soil mixture of the soil, I will show with you again on the next episode, on the next few episodes maybe, on the preparing and how to help you to prevent the problem, okay? And what is would be good for the finger root to grow and extending their rooting better, and when harvesting, how to make it easier to harvest. So the soil play a very big factor there. I have to explain about the soil for finger root specifically in the other episode. Over here, what we can do is that we can try to remove this part of it, okay, to repot it. But if you grow directly this one into your potted one, what you need to do, you need to cover. You need to use the extra soil here to cover, okay? You need to use the extra soil to cover. So this way, it will be better and then it grow. So anyhow, for the commission wise, it will be around 8 months to 1 year, okay? For the home grow, maybe slightly shorter than that because you're not really looking to the weight to sell. So maybe for the home grow, you can just slowly harvesting partially in time to come, like let's say after 6-7 months, you can have a tiny little part that you can collect for using in your kitchen. So what we're gonna do with this when it's already coming up, you can relocate it. And when you relocate it, and as I say, this one, this is already been about few months kashai. For certain people, for certain grower, I will show you something that is I'm gonna do this in the very
จังคูเวตOkay, what I'm gonna do is that I would like to show you guys how actually the grasshai you can even duplicate more from the one plant. Okay, all right. We having this with us here. Oh wow. Okay, I think this is very very unexpected, because you know why? This one is only about not so long. It's only few months only, and we already have this kind of result. So, okay, guys, as you can see here, the result is so nice. So, what happened is that I want to explain to you. If you find it very difficult to getting this and propagate or duplicate the grasshai, okay, the costing is very high for this. What you can do is that.From this plant that you are growing here, okay, and it's growing around one plant. In fact, it can grow to be many plants from one head. It can grow to this one. You can see it's the four, and then one more of the young one coming up here. So it can grow to four. And if from there, in this stage that you are doing, in fact, you can remove this, and then you use this to grow as one plant.So from one head, you can grow around 3, 4 or more if it's healthy enough. Okay, you can duplicate it like that. And when you're doing it, I will share with you on the details of growing the grasshai for commercial. Okay, and it's a very very worth the effort, because the grasshai is one of the choice that is less problem, less diseases, and easy to take care.You don't need to worry at all so much. Sometimes the only thing that you need to take care of is the rotten part, the root there, the water, rain, and all these kind of things that make it quite winter on that area only. But if you prepare your planter soils well, get ready for this, I can tell you all these problems can be prevented beforehand. So I hope you enjoy the tips for today on how we duplicate and propagate the grasshai from just one head like this.You from one of this bunch of this, you can break it up into a few. From there, you grow already. You having this stage of the grasshai, you repotted it, and then certain other plant, it will be coming up bushy like that. Okay, 3 to 4 to 5, and from there you still can removing it and try to again to duplicate it. So you multiply this way, you will have lots and lots and lots of grasshai or the finger root to use.Alright, hoping you enjoy the today video. The grasshai series is gonna be a very long story, but I will try to share with you time to time, until if you want to do it for the commission, you will have enough confidence to do it yourself. Alright, thank you for watching today, and we see you again next video. Thanks.